afternoon, folks. This is Gray Eagle in Florida. We've got a prophecy report today. Got a couple of news stories out there about wild animals attacking people, which is predicted in the Revelation. But first, the Florida weather report. 84 degrees right now, sunny, and no rain until Sunday. We got 0% rain today, 10% Saturday, 10% Monday, and 20% Tuesday. But usually it doesn't rain unless it's 40% or more. So we're not going to worry too much about the rain. Now on with the prophecy reports. This comes from WorldNet Daily, and the headline reads, "Huge wave of huge alligators wreaking havoc across the southern states." Now this is what you would call kind of a preliminary run-up to the tribulation period. These animals are getting ready to start turning on people. And that actually fulfills Revelation 6:8. "And I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death, and Hell followed." Now, we've already seen that in Egypt. YouTube video. "And power was given unto them over the fourth part of the earth to kill with the sword, kill with hunger, and kill with death, and with the beasts of the earth." Now that's the key right there. The key, kill with the beasts of the earth. That's Revelation 6:8, and that's the King James version. I'll post the links of the two stories I have here in the See More. So if you click See More, you can go read the newspaper or the news articles. And the second one I seen on Fox News this morning, where a young girl got bit by a coyote in New York City. And that's on New York Post. And that headline reads, "Coyote that attacked a five-year-old girl has rabies, so she's going to have to get shots." Matter of fact, she's going to have to get a rabies shot. She said she didn't want the shots, but she's just a little 5-6-year-old girl, and I don't blame her. Those shots, I understand, are extremely painful. But about a month ago, I was coming home from shopping, the store that I shop at mostly. Would want me to mention their name here. But about 6 o'clock in the evening, I come back. I was on my scooter. I can't walk very well. I have a tendency to fall down when I walk a lot because I got diabetes, and my feet are numb and painful from that. So I have a scooter. I go down there in a scooter. About 6 o'clock of Saturday evening, about 4 weeks ago, I was coming home, and I got home and close to home, across the street actually from my house, and I seen a coyote run across the our front lawn and run into the back. At least he ran into the back of the neighbor's yard, where he run into the back of the house. On the north side of the house was we have a gate and a fence, and it's closed off, so he had to run through the neighbor's backyard. And it was clearly a coyote there. Quite distinguishable from a dog with their long, slender snout. So I know, in fact, my daughter lives here in Florida, and she's seen several of them. She's had them attack and kill her chickens and other animals. She's seen bears down here, and I think a bobcat. But that is pretty rare in the city here, but coyotes are not rare at all. City have had other news articles where coyotes have been spotted in New York City, but they're being spotted apparently in a lot of cities. And so beyond the lookout, we gotta worry about terrorists. We gotta worry about junked up, narcotized mass assassins in our schools, and now we gotta worry about the animals turning on us. So you see an animal, Larry Taylor put it this way, recently an news article about a 7-foot beast was seen. And he said, if you see something 7 foot, don't touch it. I say run the opposite direction. But that's it for Gray Eagle's 48's prophecy report for today. I haven't done one of these in a while. It's about time. I've been wanting to do one, and then finally I come across a couple articles that fulfill some end times prophecy. So we'll let you know about it. The next time I see another one, I'll do another one. The eagle is out. Not down, and not out forever. Thanks, folks. Bye.